the solution to the problem of the white rhino surplus and their overabundance in Umfolozi especially was to find a second market. That game ranching industry was based on primarily venison production and a certain amount of tourism. There was very little demand for white rhino. And the reason for that was that pre-CITES, it was up to the various state conservation bodies, such as the Natal Parks Board, to create statutory protection for wildlife. This was divided into categories of protection, depending on how rare or endangered the animal was. And for years, the white rhino had been accorded the ultimate protection, specially protected. It meant no hunting, no use whatsoever other than passive tourism. That put us into a very tight corner. We had no demand coming from the game ranching sector. The thought was bandied about that perhaps the time has come when, such as with Impala or Zebra or Nyala, the time had come to cull. And of course, culling was part and parcel of adaptive management in those days. All animal populations had to be subjected to control of one kind or another. Kruger Park was doing it with elephant and buffalo. We were doing it on a similar scale. There was not a murmur from the public. They allowed us to get on with the job, and we continued with that management philosophy right through the years, removing animals live and culling where there was no opportunity to sell them on to private ranchers. Well, the solution to the problem of the white rhino surplus and their overabundance in Umfolozi especially was to find a second market. And the only way we could do that, the only way which we could find an outlet, was to deregulate. And that is what we did. We took them from the specially protected list and we put them on the protected list, along with reedbuck, rhinola, kudu, and a host of other species where they could be hunted under license. That was the trigger for one of the most amazing, you might say, turnarounds of an endangered species. You might say that the animals were safe and sound in state parks. Yes, but the fact is that it was the private sector which at that stage did not want rhino whatsoever. Rhino required a great deal of capital investment in fencing, bomas, and there was still the chance then that the rhino, once placed on a 2,000 hectare game ranch, would escape and run amok in neighbouring lands, causing all sorts of problems. So they were not a popular animal, coupled with the fact that they ate the same grass that impala and nyala and wildebeest and zebra ate, which meant that they were in competition. And yet there was no investment value. You couldn't make any money out of a rhino. And as a result of that, this was simply a case of tying up a new market through the use of a legislative change